been really hectic. We have to go to the travel agency to pick up our JR exchange voucher. So then once we are in Japan,
that we ordered like an hour before.
Not even an hour, like 40 minutes. Yeah. And then that will let us exchange for the real ticket once we arrive in Japan. And the JR pass we can use for basically all the Tokyo Metro lines.
Yes.
I think. Not exactly sure.
Hopefully
but
we can.
But it's a pretty good ticket if you're traveling around Tokyo and if you're going to like Osaka or Kyoto. This is our second trip of the year out of the country. How excited are you for Japan?
So excited. Dude, we were already planning for our next trip. We haven't even gone yet.
Yeah, last night I was already thinking about going there for the second time. I'm like, when's the next time we could go again?
Oh, yeah.
And we haven't even set foot in Japan. But like, it's gonna be so fun.
We'll see you in Tokyo.
Okay, bye.
Make you feel like it was our
destiny. Good morning. Last night was one hell of a night. Well, anyway, on a serious note, we spent forever trying to like find the correct directions to get to our Airbnb. The girls at the information desk were really nice, but they had trouble finding the address. So then we just resorted to the instructions given by the Airbnb host. So we did that. We got on the train from the airport to take us to the station that would let us transfer to Shibuya. But then we ended up going the wrong way. We went to Yokohama when we were supposed to go to Shinagawa. We had to get off and then go on the other side and take that train back to where we started. And that was like 30 stops.
Yeah, well, I don't know why that happened, cause
yeah, that was, we literally stayed on the train for 30 stops to get to where we were supposed to get off.
But it only took like 5 stops to get to Yokohama, so we're like,
yeah, it took us quicker to get there than to get back. After we got off at Shinagawa, we took the JR
Yamanote.
We took the JR Yamanote line to Shibuya and there were so many people. Oh my gosh. It was at midnight and it looked like it was rush hour. The trains were so crowded and everyone was just like shuffling and I don't know, it was very busy.
Oh, can you tell them how there was no elevators?
Oh yeah. And like since we had to do a lot of transfers, we had to like go up and down the stairs a lot through the stations. And a lot of those stations only had staircases. There weren't like elevators or escalators for us. And we had suitcases. Like my friend Cynthia, she had to lug 2 suitcases up and down the stairs. And they weren't even like short flights of stairs. They were like, they were about 40 steps. So we did that multiple times. And there were a lot of people in the mix. So yeah, after we took the JR line to Shibuya, from there we took the Denotoshi line, which is a private line. We took it to the Shidagaya district and got off at Senjinjaya. And from there, we followed the instructions to look for Airbnb. We got to the Rice Street quickly, but the actual house, it took us about an hour. We were just walking back and forth with our suitcases and the suitcases were rolling on the gravel. It was making really loud noises and everyone was sleeping. After what seemed like forever, we finally found the place. Oh yeah, so like at one point we split up to look on our own, and when I came, like, we left the suitcases at a certain spot and then we went our own ways to look for the place. And then after a while, I couldn't really find it, so I went back to the suitcase area and Cynthia wasn't there. So I'm like, oh, okay. So she's just like looking on her own for a bit more. And then after, I think, like 15, 20 minutes, I was starting to get really worried because there was no sign of her and it was like a narrow alleyway. And I'm pretty sure I would have like hurt her or something. And it was dark, it was cold, it was just me and the 3 suitcases. I seriously thought she was gonna get kidnapped or she got kidnapped, or like she was so exhausted. Oh, I forgot to tell you that part. I thought she was so exhausted that she passed out. That she passed out in the middle of the street. And even if like I called for her, she wouldn't know because she was like dead asleep. So so I was like running left and right looking for her, and I was getting mad. Like in the beginning I was getting freaked out, but then I was like mad because like she should know to come back because there's a second person here. And then what seemed like for ages, she popped out of nowhere. And then yeah, I was also yelling her name. It was like a whisper yell. It was like, Cynthia! Because everyone was sleeping and I didn't know what to do. But that didn't help because she didn't answer me. Anyway, we regrouped and we were able to locate the place on the map. Like, it didn't show the exact street, but it pinpointed to like the area. So we followed that dot on the map and we found it because the silver box, the host attached the silver box key on the gas meter, and that was the indicator that we found the right place. And we were so happy because that was like at 2 a.m. in US time. That was 8 a.m. in the morning or 9 a.m. in the morning. So technically we did not sleep for 24 hours. What a night. That is all.
Say hi. Hello.
She is
my face.
She is all made up. Mm-hmm. And we're ready to go. It's really warm here. Like, I'm sitting by the window and the sun's...
Yeah, because the heater too.
Oh, that too. Oh, I forgot about that.
Oh, and the heater's really weird because it only lets you turn it to
30
degrees Celsius. So it's really freaking cold.
Yeah.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
We're from Japan. Oh, it's our first day. Mm-hmm. First full day.
The Meiji Shrine is behind us. That's the entrance gate. All right, let's go in. Update, we shopped a lot. She got a pair of shoes for $20. She got two pairs of the same shoes with different colors.
And now we're looking. She got the other color.
Yeah, now we're looking at hair dyes. Day two! And we have friends!
Yeah.
Yay. Who joined us.
Kelly and Sharon.
Yesterday, after we went to the Meiji Shrine, we went to Takashida Dori. Yeah.
Shop.
Now we're trying to figure out what we want for breakfast. So heading into 7-Eleven.
This looks interesting. Tomato and egg.
like one. It's almost two.
Yeah.
Oh, it's two. We went in at like 12:30. Now we're going to the temple and
take lots of pictures.
Lots of photos.
Actually not that late, but it was a very tiresome
Yeah, day. It feels later than it actually is.
Good morning.
Let me give you a tour of our Airbnb in Tokyo. This is the living room. There's a futon there, and there's a big sofa there. And then to the left is the bedroom. The light stopped working yesterday. Over here we have our kitchen. So that's the entrance. And I like how, like, when you first come in, you take off your shoes here and then you come up here. Kitchen area. It's really small. Sink, fridge, microwave, oven. In Japan, they separate their trash by combustible garbage, glass, plastic bottles, and cans. This is the toilet. They have the shower and the toilet separate. And for this shower, that whole part is also the shower. So you take off your shoes and step in there too. Turn the light on. We don't really use the sink because you've got to like go through all the, you've got to step on the wetness of it too. Get there, and the toilet is very minimal. So when you flush here, the water comes from up there too. Very interesting. That is it. Quick, right? Yeah. Yogurt drink for breakfast. It's pretty good. Tokyo day 3. Yesterday the yukata was really fun. Mm-hmm. We didn't really talk about how it went yesterday.
Because we couldn't.
Because we were too busy with getting our pictures taken.
And we couldn't even, we didn't even show like how they put on our yukata and everything.
Yeah, there were a lot of layers. Formal. We dressed up, we walked over to the Sansoji Temple and there were a bunch of people. And a lot of people wanted to take pictures with us.
I think it's because all of our kimonos matched.
Mm-hmm. We had like a pink and floral theme with all of our yukatas. It was like unintentional too, so that was really cool. There were different groups of people like from different nationalities too.
And they're like, oh, we're so excited because we had to take pictures with real Japanese lady.
And
we're like,
whoa, thank you. And then when we told them we're from America, they were so shocked. Right? Some of them were pretty shocked.
Like, what? America,
Jin? Oh my god. Yeah.
They're like talking to us in Japanese and we're like, we have no idea what you're saying.
I almost forgot about that. Today's New Year's Eve. So we'll see like if some stores are open and some are not.
wasting time. Yeah, we came alive. Our souls intertwined when we kissed the sky. Yeah.
And you made me back. We're back in Shibuya.
Feels that you're feeling, staring at your ceiling, wondering what I'm up to. I'm better.
I was trying to blow my hair out of my face. Heading to Shibuya 109. Sensoji Temple, and we count down to New Year's.
Yes.
Last night was our first experience hailing a taxi.
Oh yeah.
At Shibuya Crossing.
Because we left at hecka late.
We got back to the train station around 2, and we found out the next train comes at 4:05.
Yep. 4:05 a.m.
Yeah. So we're like, oh no, where are we waiting for that? So we just decided to do a taxi, and man, people were aggressive. Or you had to be aggressive to get one. Since everything is the opposite here, even for their taxis, if it's a green light, that means it's occupied. And if it's red, that means it's open.
Yeah. We were sitting there and a taxi was coming and these people came out of nowhere and just took it. And yeah. We're like, what just happened?
Yeah. They walked in front of us and got the car.
Yeah, we're like, okay.
But we got one eventually.
We got one.
And today's plans are to go to Yuno Park and Akihabara.
So cool.
Yeah.
All the
gaming
manga,
and anime.
We'll go so far as we please. Giddy up and go, man. Different place, different time. All the stars are in their prime.
Wondering why it's so dark, it's because it's 5 a.m. and we're going to the Tsukuji market today. So we're trying to make it there as early as we can. And I think the train starts running at 5, so that's why we're leaving right now. Going to the Museum of Science and Innovation, but it opens at 10, so we have an hour left. We're gonna figure out what to do for an hour. Day 6.
I was feeling very refreshed compared from yesterday's morning vlog. Because we got up at 4 yesterday. Yeah, 4 yesterday to go to the fish market. What's it called?
Tsukiji.
Tsukiji Fish Market, but then we found out that they were closed for the New Year holiday. But we got sushi around there and it was pretty good. After we went to the fish market, we went to Odaiba for the Mirakai Science and Tech Museum. That was fun.
And we went to Asuma.
Yeah, yeah, the robot. Then after the museum, we came back. We wanted to do a little bit of shopping, so we went to Takashita Street again. Mm-hmm. And there were so many people.
Yeah, because after New Year's sale,
yeah.
Like, what the goodness.
We shopped for a good like 2 or 3 hours. I tried this at the Takashita Dori where they had like the fresh ones, and it was really good. It tasted like fries, but more like it was softer, and yeah, this is good. I'm not sure about this version though.
The club isn't the best place to find the lovers, so the bar is where I go. Me and my friends at the table doing shots, drinking fast, and then we talk slow. Come over and start up a conversation with just me, and trust me.
The place we're waiting, it's approximately an hour away. And we haven't eaten anything since we woke up.
I haven't eaten since like last night.
Oh my god.
We had that cream bun.
There's not even any benches when we shopped. I feel like sitting isn't a thing for them when they're shopping. I'll
give it a chance now, take my hand, stop. Found the man on the jukebox and then we start to dance. And now I'm singing like, girl, you know I want your love. Your love was handmade for somebody like me. Come on now, follow my lead. I may be crazy, don't mind me. Say, boy, let's not talk too much. Grab on my waist and put that body on me. Come on now.
Made it to Shinjuku from Takashita Dori. Apparently this small connects to the station.
Follow my lead. Come on now, follow my lead. And I fill up the plate. We talk for hours and hours about the sweet and the sour and how your family's doing okay. And leaving, getting a taxi, kissing the backseat, tell the driver make the radio play. And I'm singing like, girl, you know I want your.
We had a big wake up call because we had to get our luggage onto the train and make it to the station by 8:30 to catch the bullet train to Kyoto.
This is all the luggage.
Carry all those luggages up and down the stairs because not every station had elevators. So, you know, it was a big workout. Finally made it to the station and we are having a little bit of a break.
Heading to Kyoto.
For somebody like me, come on now, follow my lead. I may be crazy, don't mind me. Say, boy, let's not talk too much. Grab on my waist and put that body on me. I'm coming now, follow my lead. I'm coming now, follow my lead. I'm in love with the shape.
We finally made it to Kyoto. We're going to the Nishiki Market right now.
Push and pull like a magnet. Although my heart is falling too.
Come on, be my baby. 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 day in Japan. We are at our second Airbnb, and let me show you around.
So when you first walk in, you take off your shoes, and that's the shoe closet. To the left is the kitchen. I don't think there's a proper stove. Bathroom, bedroom.
Yeah.
And then we have a balcony right here. There's the washer and dryer.
This is the hallway that leads to our Airbnb. It kind of looks like a motel, but it's an apartment setup. This is the view we get. It's pretty nice. I am not your Casanova. You and Romeo ain't never been friends. It's day 8 and we're in Kyoto!
Yay!
Yay! Today's plans are the Arashiyama Park, Fushi Nari Taisha Shrine. From there, we're going to Nara, which is a deer park. Now we're just walking to the train station. Can you see how much I really love you? Gonna sing it to you time and time again. Oh, Casanova. Casanova. This is the bamboo park at Arashiyama, and there's just these tall bamboo shoots. We're now heading to the Fushimi Nari Taisha Shrine, and we're taking the JR line. So we're heading to the JR station. Every man deserves a good woman. We didn't have enough time to go to Nara Park, but we're in Osaka. The Kuromon Market.
Kuromon Ichiba.
Ichiba Market. It's indoors, which is a good thing because it's really cold here.
Oh my god. Time is so much better spent, baby, with a woman just like you in my life. So let me love you. Me up inside, I wanna hold you, baby. So let me squeeze you. Don't you know that I'll be on my knees for you, baby? Oh, baby. I am not your Casanova. It's apparently 42 degrees.
It doesn't feel cold.
Mm-hmm. Hence the ice cream. Our last night in Kyoto. Today we went to Osaka.
We were supposed to go to Nara.
It was a very spontaneous decision.
Yeah, we're like, okay, Nara. No, Osaka.
Yeah, we couldn't make it to Nara. So I'm like, oh, okay, Osaka. And we actually got to see a lot of it. Mostly the shopping and the downtown area. We went to a ramen bar for our last meal. And it was oishi. Yeah. And we got a selfie. We got a selfie with the ramen chefs. The photo wasn't that great of a quality.
and we looked drunk.
Yeah, and the lighting was super, super yellow. And we looked red and oily. I think the chefs looked better than us. But it's okay.
It's okay. It's a memory.
Yes. I'm headed back to our Airbnb and going to pack, leave tomorrow, head to the airport, and go back home. Japan was everything I expected it to be, and more. No bad words about Japan. Never been friends. I can just say. Ohayo from Kyoto. It's our last day. Today is gonna be a day of traveling.
So much traveling.
Yeah. We checked out a little past 11.
There was a lady standing behind us, standing outside the doors.
Yeah, somebody ran the doorbell because we were supposed to check out at 11, so we were late. Now we're heading to the station to get to the Kyoto station where we will be taking the JR.
The Shinkansen.
Shinkansen back to Tokyo, and then from Tokyo we're going to Shinagawa station and heading to the airport. It's a long day of traveling. First,
on the ground, and then up in the air.
Really love you. Gonna sing it to you time and time again.
Casanova. Boarding time, we're leaving. Been on the road for the entire day today. And it's nighttime.
Trying to hit that 10K. The plane has taken off. Oh. We're at
something. Oh, you don't press it. Oh. Okay then. Isn't that Solomon?